all the time. We're saying, God didn't do this. God didn't do this. There's all this murder, all these things that God didn't take care of. But when was the last time we did something for Him? When was the last time we went up and down the street to say, I need to let everybody know that that's my God, I love Him, He's the one. When was the last time that we just helped somebody on the street and said, literally said these exact words, here you are, sir, this is for you, God wants you to have it and walk away. You gave all the glory to God, didn't mention your name or anything. You did it for God. When was the last time every one of us did at least one thing for God without being asked every day? Not sometimes. All of us are in fault. We think about ourselves, but when we start thinking about God, God starts thinking about us. You need that job, and you've been praising God, says, I'm going to take, you know, it's like a family. You ever seen those businesses that have families? You hate to work for them. You know why? Because they only hire family. Promotions only go to people they know and they like. And that first go, even if they don't like the family member, they're going to give it to them. And you're like, I've been here 15 years. That guy doesn't even go to school, and he's in charge of me. And some say, he's part of his family. Well, you know what? You're the family of God. God will look after you. He will take care of you. He may not take care of you the way that you want Him to take care of you, but He will make sure you eat. He will give you something over your head. He will put clothes on your body. We talked about that in Bible study. He will take care of you, but you have to take care of Him. And you know, if you got a brother that talks trash about you and everything, you don't want him at the family reunions. You don't want him here. You actually disown him. You know, they do stuff to the family. You don't want to disown my God. Go blasphemy. You don't want to do that. Don't deny God. Because when you deny God, God's going to deny you. He says that plainly in the Bible. You did things in my name, but I don't even know you. The question is, I'm going to close with this. In order to get God to talk to you, in order to have a relationship with God, the question is this. I'm not asking, do you know about God? I'm asking, do you know God? We all know about the president. We all know about other people, but do you know them? The question is, do you know God? Not do you know about Him? And the only way to know God is have God inside and submit. As I close in here, as I said before, the answer is in the Word of God, the Bible. Every question you have, the answer is there. Every question. From murder to whatever you ask. And yes, brother, how to get God to talk to you is in the Bible. It's actually in there. But we have to trust God. We have to have faith in God to do things for us on His time. Like the little story I read. God did not give this person in that story the things he wanted when he wanted it, because he already knew what was going to happen. So maybe, like Brother Ed, maybe he didn't get a job before this job that he got because it wasn't good enough for him. God wanted him to have the job he had there, so He made him late or didn't have other things fall through just so he could go to this job interview to have the job he has now. Trust God, and God will trust you.